Hello and welcome to Inside the Capitol. I'm Shannon Keith with Representative Pam DeLissio. And Pam, you are here today to talk about this activity here in the Capitol regarding redistricting. There are some guests all the way from California who have presented what they're doing to the Senate, members of the Senate. You and Representative Samuelson hosted a roundtable just a short while ago. What's going on with Pennsylvania and the need for, or the call for, redistricting?
Well, this is our current update for the efforts on having Pennsylvania have an independent redistricting commission that is all citizens, as opposed to the legislature, which is how current redistricting happens. So in the House, it's House Bill 722, and the Senate, it's Senate Bill 22. And this morning, the Senate State Government Committee held a hearing on not only Senate Bill 22, but two other bills as well that have to do with various aspects of redistricting reform. And the group Fair Districts PA, which is a coalition of citizens and grassroots organizations who really want to see this particular vision become a reality, also testified. Unfortunately, the commissioners who were in from California, who have lived through this process about 8 or 9 years ago in California, there wasn't room on the schedule for them to testify, but they were members of the audience, as I was myself. But I had the opportunity to hear them at some length both last night and then earlier this afternoon. As you mentioned, Rep. Samuelson and myself hosted them at a round table for legislators of the House as well as other advocates.
And why is there a difference when you involve people who aren't legislators in the notion of districting or deciding how the election maps are drawn up?
Well, right now, Pennsylvania has a notorious reputation for gerrymandering. And as some citizens may be aware, the congressional maps were challenged back in June of 2017, and the Pennsylvania Supreme Court issued an order in January that those particular congressional maps had to be redrawn in time for this May 15th primary. That did happen over the last couple of weeks, and we have have been labeled remedial maps. They're available online for anybody to see, and candidates for Congress will be running under those remedial maps. But that's a very short-term solution and only for congressional seats. What we're looking for is that longer-term, what we hope is a permanent solution for not only the congressional districts, but for state representative and state Senate districts as well. And the next redistricting for state reps, state Senate, and Congress will be 2021. So the clock is ticking. There are some timeline issues here that say we need to get this done by July 6th of this year, because the legislation is a constitutional amendment. And then this will take the legislature out of the process and put it in the hands of qualified citizens.
And if people are interested in finding out more about this, you had mentioned that there are some town halls.
The commissioners from California are conducting a town hall tonight in State College, tomorrow at Montgomery County Community College at 2 o'clock, and then tomorrow in Philadelphia at the Pennsylvania Academy of Fine Arts. These events are being recorded and aired. I know the Pennsylvania Cable Network aired last night's town hall meeting at 9 o'clock this morning. And there are certainly video that will be made available on Fair Districts PA's website. Their website is fairdistrictpa.com.
And as always, if people do have more or want to get more information, they can reach out to your office and your staff and they'll be able to find out more.
They can. Our district office number is 215-482-8726. And I'd just like to say that the two takeaways I had from these last 2 days of events surrounding the concept of redistricting reform are the fact that as a result of California having going down this path in 2010, in that redistricting, the public trust went up, and the public confidence went up in the state legislature out there. It had been a whopping low 10% in 2008, and now it's north of 50%. So that's a really good thing. People, citizens feel engaged, they feel heard. We want, some of us, many of us, I hope, in the legislature want that same thing for the citizens of Pennsylvania. And it certainly appears that many of our citizens want that as well.
It does indeed. Well, thanks so much for stopping by to tell us about this issue and to share the information about the town halls. It's always a great pleasure.
Thank you.